I like that song. I love the violin stuff. I love the lyrics and the melody. The bass music behind it was easy to pick up, but good song. This is a weird song so far. Again, don't lose hope. Like that's the theme. That was interesting. You can catch a star if the sky is falling down. There's a golden lining up in every single cloud. You can take a frown, turn it all the way around. All the way around, all the way around. A fortune teller told me the power's in your mind. You might see a cliff, but I see a way to fly. Flipping off the flop, now I just enjoy the ride. Just enjoy the ride, yeah, I just enjoy the ride. What a time to be alive. Don't say goodbye. Wait a minute. That sounded like a sample of a song on purpose. That na 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 goodbye song. This one play out to get into the next song, but I want to share a few thoughts. So yeah, that same theme as I'm reading through the lyrics here again, feet to the fire, it's not a funeral we're attending, it's just the beginning. It is all different ways to say we can overcome this, you know. Not the end of the world, cry through the tears. It's the same messaging said differently with different music, you know. So I definitely feel like, yeah, I'm pretty confident that that is kind of maybe probably gonna be the ongoing theme of the rest of this album. As far as the music, I really like the effect that I'm hearing. It kind of it reminded me of an Eminem song. I don't know why. Maybe it was because of the hi-hat snare hit and then the effect that she's using, the synth effect. I also liked how in the beginning, the first, I don't know, 30 seconds of the song, I was kind of really confused where the melody was going to go and where the lyrics were going to go, because she like talks really slow and really fast and then kind of repeats words that you're not expecting to be repeated. So it was kind of fun to be surprised by that as well. But so let's finish, let's let this one finish out and kind of go straight into the next track. Oh, and the sampling of that song is really cool too. Goodbye, Cal. So Smile, I've heard this song, so I've got the video ready to go. We're just gonna pull it right up here and watch the video instead, because I've heard the song before, and I have a reaction to the song, but I've never seen the video, so let's check it out. I feel my thoughts on those lyrics were correct. Watch the original reaction. That's funny.
Win with love.
This is a really cool animation. This just took a long time to make. I feel like this is really smart, by the way. I think this is a really clever and fun video. It's super entertaining. Kind of makes me like the song more because you're getting a visual representation of what she was saying. I think in my original reaction, I wanted a little bit more melody. I liked the music, but wanted more melody. And this, there's kind of an energy to the video that kind of livens up the song a little bit for me. I feel like this is also a really smart. So for, you know, for every creative endeavor, you have to deal with logistics, right? How am I actually going to pull this off? You know, oh, let's make a movie where somebody jumps off a building and then flies in the air. Okay, we have to get a real live human body and throw them off a building, or we got to use CG or whatever, right? Anyway, it's an aside. But what I'm saying is, it looks like she was still pregnant when she shot this video. And so this is a really, I feel like if it were 5 years ago and Katy Perry had written this song, she would literally be dressing up as these characters and going into these world green screen style, just like California Girls or something, right? She'd be dressing up as the clown, as the Candyland character, and not just in makeup, but literally running around in these worlds. So I think it was really smart to logistically think about her health and her well-being, you know, being late in her pregnancy, to not have her go through all that, to just dress up as the characters and then have this really cool, flashy computer stuff in the video game kind of be an avatar for what she's trying to get across or what she would have performed herself if she could. So it's kind of, it's smart logistically and it's entertaining creatively. And so I think that's really cool. Always the colors in her videos. She's chasing down some humble pie. Yeah. That's funny. I think that's the first time I have heard that song since the reaction. So it was fun to re-listen to that song and to get to see the music video for the first time. So yeah, I thought the music video was really fun. It was very clever to have like this video game avatar go through these challenges and then to finally get the humble pie and slam it right in her own face. I thought that was pretty funny. So really entertaining video. And again, smartly made. And I have to imagine, I'm just me, boring white dude, but I have to imagine it feels good to see this pop icon sex symbol feel comfortable bearing her body in all of its beautiful pregnant glory. I'm sure there's a lot of people that maybe would have hidden that or maybe been self-conscious about that, but she puts it out all on display, whether it's the Daisies video or this smile video. She just says, yeah, I'm pregnant. That's the fact of life, and I am me. I'm still me, and this is still my body, so I'm going to display it how I want to in the pursuit of my career and my creative passion, and kind of be a role model for other people out there that want to feel comfortable in their bodies as well and respect the creation of human life, you know? So that has to speak to a lot of people, or maybe I'm an idiot. I don't know. But I just know personally, again, as a boring white dude, you don't see a lot of pregnant people on camera like that. It's, even on like sitcoms, they always hide them behind a pillow or, you know, you can't affect the storyline or whatever. So it's cool to see.